But in the diving pool last night in the women's 3 metre springboard, no Australian made it through. But a little girl, 14 years of age, Rachel Wilkes, really caught the eye. She finished in 14th place, and she only had her first major competition back in April last year. She's competed at the national gymnastics titles. She missed out there. She was very disenchanted with gymnastics, and she was discovered by Steve Foley. She was a controversial selection because she beat the Commonwealth champion Jenny Donnett into the Australian team. But she really did perform with distinction, and she's one to watch for the future. She's going to be a medal threat, I would think, at Barcelona when you consider that was her first international meet. Dawn Fraser, she's a great prospect.
She's beautiful. She's very graceful, and I think that coming from gymnastics has really helped her up. But she's just got a lovely flair about her on that board.
We're talking about Hayley Lewis before we go into our next round.
15-year-old Brisbane schoolgirl Rachel Wilkes has only been diving for 2 years, and although she sometimes frustrates her coach, Foley rates her the best natural talent he's seen.
Yes, I did some coaching at All Hallows School in Brisbane there, helping a friend, and she was there taking up diving lessons because she was a gymnast, and she just thought it was a nice transition to do a few dives. And I just spotted her and I said, have you ever had a lesson? And she said, no, and I fell over backwards and did four cartwheels.
Rachel, who won 2 bronze medals at the recent World Junior titles in Sweden, added another gold in the 3 metre springboard at Chandler, narrowly beating Liz Shave of Western Australia.
Successful transition. Elite athletes are switching from gymnastics to diving with outstanding results. Experts say the switch is logical and means a new wave of diving excellence in Australia. Well, on the eve of the National Diving Championships in Adelaide, Kim Watkins spoke to 3 of Australia's Olympic hopefuls.
A gymnastics hall may seem an odd place to find 3 of Australia's up-and-coming divers, but these girls are steadily proving the knockers wrong with their incredible successes in the pool. April Adams, Rachel Wilkes and Kelly Lata are former gymnasts who've swapped their beam and parallel bars for the springboard and 10-metre platform. The Chinese have dominated the sport for years, but according to Australian Institute of Sport head diving coach Steve Foley, the influx of gymnasts into the sport will thrust Australians into the forefront of international competition.
Probably accelerated the whole process. Normally it takes maybe 8 to 10 years to be a diver, whereas what's happening now, because of their gymnastic background, they're becoming, you know, like excellent divers, world-class divers in half the time.
Australia's number one platform diver, April Adams, was the first to make the move from gymnastics. Once ranked 2nd in New South Wales, she gave it all away to dive.
With Rachel and Kelly, they went from gymnastics to diving. What I did was I did diving and gymnastics together at the same time, and then I actually gave away the diving and went to the gymnastics, and then I came back to the diving.
She'd been diving seriously for the last 5 years and was a triple gold medalist 4 times at the Australian Championships. Rachel Wilkes and Kelly Lather are the rising stars. 15-year-old Rachel has been diving for 19 months and has been compared with Chinese world champion Gao Min with her natural easy style. She shocked the diving world when she qualified to represent Australia at the World Championships just 12 months after taking up the sport. In doing so, she edged out Commonwealth triple gold medalist Jenny Donnett. But her move into diving did take some prompting.
There was this camp at school where Steve said, come join my club, and I said, no, I did gymnastics because I really loved it at stake. And then later in the year, I was having trouble with it and everything, and so I decided to see what diving was like, and I knew I could always go back to gymnastics if I didn't like it. Then I decided to stay with it because I loved it so much.
Steve Foley says her talent is limitless.
She's just naturally talented, gifted. As a coach, it's exciting but sometimes frightening because you've got to know when to hold them back or when to push them. But somebody with so much talent like Rachel has, it's great for Australian diving.
21-year-old Kelly Lather was one of Australia's top 3 gymnasts and was a silver medalist on beam at the Edinburgh Commonwealth Games.
Well, I didn't actually change straight away. I gave up gymnastics entirely and went home, decided to have a break from sport altogether. And I got so bored and frustrated with doing nothing that I thought I want to compete again, and I thought a new sport would be a good challenge, so I decided to take up diving because it's very similar and I have done a little bit before, so it was fun.
Originally from Tasmania, Kelly moved to the Institute of Sport in Brisbane to train. After just 12 months in the sport, she's already ranked 12th in Australia on the springboard and 9th on the 3 metre.
The fundamental training involved in gymnastics is a big benefit for diving because you've got the body coordination, the strength and flexibility, which is a great combination, and you've already got your aerial sense and how to somersault and twist, so it's just a matter of putting it all together in the diving room.
April, Rachel and Kelly share one common goal, to win gold at Barcelona, and while it's a mighty ambition, it's not out of reach.
We have probably the best chance we've ever had, and I think Barcelona is probably going to be the most exciting and the best Olympics for diving we've ever seen. And at this stage, I'd be surprised if we didn't equal or better Valvetto's 5th in 1984, which is Australia's best result. So I think Barcelona is going to be fantastic. And of course, you can see it on Channel 7, so it'll be great.
Steve said you can see it on Channel 7. Good luck to Rachel, Kelly and April. Pretty tough diving at any level, particularly World Championships and Olympic Games. And Noble presents the following stats as we look at how Australians have done at the Olympic Games in diving. In men's springboard, our best performances, Stephen Foley himself in Los Angeles in 84, the great Don Wagstaff in 1968, they both finished 8th. And way back in 1924, Richmond Eve 5th. We've had no result from the top 8 in platform for men, but in women's, in springboard, Jenny Donnett was 10th in Seoul in 88. That was a remarkable performance. Valerie McFarlane was 6th in 1980. She became Valerie Beddoe in 1984, where she finished 5th on the platform. She was 7th in 1980, and Maggie Epley 7th way back in 1932. So Val Beddoe's 5th place, the highest ever by an Australian in diving at the Olympics. Thanks to Mobile for those stats. We take a break. It's that poll Tony Dodder makes, or Sheffield Shield final after this.